back here in WYCR. That was a short break because we're ready to get right back to the NFL mock draft. John Seiko here with Kevin Barnett. And Kevin, let's dive right into it. At the 16th pick, right smack dab in the middle of the draft, you have the most talked about team in football, whether it is relevant or not, the Dallas Cowboys. Oh, there's been rumors that they're going to try and take Johnny Manziel, everything they got.
And Jerry Jones shot that down. Shot it down today.
Rightfully so, I believe.
Which would be a terrible idea. You have a good quarterback. Granted, Tony Romo is a certified non-winner. Man is not a winner, and I hope he continues to not be a winner.
Uh-huh.
It's true. I mean, he's won one playoff game, so yeah. He's not a winner. I hope this team continually is bad, like they were on defense last year.
It's because you're a Giants fan, man.
Can you blame me? Don't you want the Jets to be the worst team ever continually?
This is completely 100% true.
This is Dallas Cowboys at number 16. They were a disaster on defense last year.
They were.
How they turned, I remember opening night, I knew their defense was a disaster because even though they turned the ball over they got six turnovers from the Giants on opening night, Matt Giants was still almost won the game.
Yeah.
That just shows how bad their defense was because we gave them a lot of those turnovers. Mm-hmm. But they got to go best defensive player available. They have needs everywhere. I don't care what what kind of system they're running. Even though they have Sean Lee, you can't rely on him to stay healthy.
Though he's great when he's healthy. I think he's fantastic.
Very good when he's healthy. I think they're going back to a 3-4 defense this year, though. And this is why I think this makes all too much sense. Best defense player on the board is C.J. Mosley out of Alabama.
C.J. Mosley, linebacker out of Alabama. Okay.
I mean, makes a lot of sense. And he could play outside, or Lee could play outside if they need to, if they still stick to the 4-3. But they were a disaster on defense. They have so many needs on that area of the ball. They have to go with the best player available, in my opinion, which would be C.J. Mosley.
I think they're going to try to improve their secondary. I got them taking Kyle Fuller out of Virginia Tech.
I have Fuller going a little lower, but I can see that.
I think that the Cowboys are trying to him because I think they will show trust in Sean Lee. Granted, I think they could improve their defensive line, losing Ware. I think that's going to be a very looming.
And taking a big gamble on Henry Melton, considering he didn't play last year.
I got Fuller. I admit it's kind of a reach. But I think that the Virginia Tech quarterback will sneak up there, and if I would make a surprise,
any
I see
first
that.
Round talent that's possible is not a reach for the Cowboys at number 16 when it comes to defense. That's how
and
bad they were.
And when you're smack dab in the middle of the round, it's like a tough. It's like who's gonna be there? Blah blah blah.
They're in the dead middle, number 16.
So that's why I got Kyle Fuller, cornerback out of Virginia Tech, going to the Dallas Cowboys. Now after the Dallas Cowboys, we have the Baltimore Ravens. Who do you got the Ravens taking at 17?
People don't realize this is kind of an area of need, though, for them. Not guard. They have the best guard in all of football. It's not even a contest. It's Marshall Yanda.
Mm-hmm. He's very, very good.
Very good. And then they have a good left tackle in UGM Monroe. But they did lose Michael Orr to Tennessee. So they don't have anyone starting on the right side. That's where I think they take Zach Martin out of Notre Dame. Mm-hmm. I had him sliding down a little bit, but they did get Steve Smith. They got their two receivers set, I think, with Steve Smith and Torrey Smith. They're sticking with Ray Rice and Flacco, how much money they paid him. Obviously, they have to stick with him. So, I've seen Eric Ebron mocked here a lot, but I mean, they never really ran two tight ends. Yes, they had two quality ones in Dixon and Pitta, but Pitta is far better. Pitta can play. They gave Pitta a nice contract. I don't think they need a tight end. I think they go best player here, and I think the best player in this case is Zach Martin.
I have them going with, I think, the best player, and that's C.J. Mosley. I think they're going to boost their linebackers even more because they love linebackers. Let's just face it.
Yes.
They love linebackers. When they see a good linebacker, they drool because they're so excited. So that's why I think C.J. Mosley, if he learns under Suggs, I mean, is there really anyone better to learn under in the NFL right now? One of the best linebackers in football. So that's why I think they're going to go C.J. Mosley. I have Zach Martin falling a lot now. I mean, I don't even have him picked yet, and we're going to 18, the Jets. So, but I got them taking C.J. Mosley because I think they love defense. They love a good linebacker when they see one. I think they can't pass it.
I see your point there for sure, though. I think that they do need help on the offensive side. But
I'm not denying it.
Yeah, which has been like their defense has always been their calling card. So.
Yeah.
Jets number 18, man. The Jets are a disaster on the wide receiver side because Eric Decker cannot do it alone.
No, I don't think Eric Decker is a number one. I think he needs to have someone else there to take the attention away. Then he's really good.
Yeah.
But I think that once you put like a top defensive back on him or cornerback, he's not going to be able to do.
Sherman made him invisible. In the
exactly.
Super Bowl. Richard Sherman was not on.
And now Darrell Revis is in your division.
Yes. And Richard Sherman was. Let's be clear. Demaryius Thomas had a monster game. Demaryius Thomas was not guarded by Richard Sherman.
Mm-hmm.
Richard Sherman was on Eric Decker, and he made Eric Decker. I thought it was a lot of money, but then the Jets overpaid for him. So,
mm-hmm.
The Jets, they need cornerbacks desperately too. But I think that their fans have been wanting offense. Because Rex Ryan is a very good coach defensively. He can develop guys on his own.
And he overexceeded so much last year with the team they had.
Yes, so I think Rex Ryan can develop these guys. That's why I have them taking, in my opinion, the best receiver on the board, even though I think it's a reach, in Odell Beckham.
Okay, Odell Beckham out of LSU.
Out of LSU. Mm-hmm. I've seen him go as high as number 12 to my Giants. So.
Ooh, I don't know about that.
Yeah, I wouldn't like that one.
I have them going wide receiver as well, but I have them going with Brandon Cooks out of Oregon State.
I've Cooks a couple of picks after this one.
So I frankly think that him and Beckham are kind of on the same page. Like, yeah. I see them as like 50-50. Yeah, yeah. So I the flip a coin, I think Cooks is the one that lands with the Jets.
I absolutely can see either one. So
That's the one I see. All right, so now moving after the Jets, you have the New Orleans Saints.
Miami Dolphins, actually.
Miami Dolphins. I apologize.
Yes.
I apologize. That's my fault. Who do you have the Miami Dolphins taking?
The Miami Dolphins, I have them going for reach here because their offensive line is a disaster. I know they just signed Brandon Albert, but they still don't have a right tackle. It's where I have them going with. It's a little bit of a reach, but I think he'll find his way in the first round. Morgan Moses, offensive tackle from West Virginia.
Mm-hmm.
I don't really know much about him, but from what I've heard, he could be developed a little bit. But with Miami, they have a lot of offensive line problems. I hear he could play any position on the line. And with how many problems they had last year within the Richie Incognito scandal and John Martin, they'll take whatever they can get talent-wise. They got a good defense. They gave a lot of money. They have solid receivers. They just need a lot of help offensive line so they can open up holes for Lamar Miller.
Mm.
And no Sean Moreno now. So
now I'm forgetting my picks because I didn't write them down because I'm stupid. But I did not have Taylor Lewan picked yet, if I remember
you
correctly.
You did not, because he has been rumored to go down a little bit because of his off the field problems.
This is where I'm going to have him going to Miami Dolphins because they need an offensive tackle desperately.
Yeah.
And I think that as you can see, you have him going pretty high. Some people have him high. Some people have him low. I have him going to the Miami Dolphins. Mm-hmm. That's
like talent wise, Lewan is a top 10 pick. It's just his character concerns are a little bit of an issue. So.
So now they get to number 20, the Arizona Cardinals, who over-exceeded last year, 10-6 record, almost made the playoffs.
They got a great coach.
They do have a great coach in Bruce Arians. Who do you see them taking with the 20th pick?
I see them taking Anthony Barr, the outside linebacker out of
UCLA. The one I had going earlier, yep.
You had him going early, and I could see that, but some teams are shaking him because is he just strictly a pass rusher? But this is kind of exactly what Arizona needs, is strictly a pass rusher. I think this kid would be a perfect fit for Arizona. He's all-world speed. He came to UCLA as a running back, and then he was a fantastic pass rusher. They got good cornerbacks in Antonio Cromartie, Patrick Peterson, and Tyrann Mathieu.
Yeah.
Don't got a lot of needs in the secondary. So, linebacker. They did just lose Carlos Dansby, but we both have CJ Mosley off the board here. This is where I think Anthony Barr makes a lot of sense.
Okay. Now again, I had Anthony Barr going to your New York Giants. Yes. But what I'm going with here, I'm going to stick with offensive tackle because I think that they could use some help on the offensive line. And as you said, they improved their secondary already, are getting Cromartie. Otherwise, I think that's where they would have looked. But I think they filled that void. So I'm going to go with the pick you had earlier, Morgan Moses.
Yes.
That's where I'm going to have him going. I have Morgan Moses out of Virginia, the senior. I have him going to the Arizona Cardinals.
Right.
All right. So there you go.
Fair enough.
21, the Green Bay Packers.
Notice, I feel like I've left one significant name out of my picks. You had Taylor Lewan, Eric Ebron.
You have him falling, and I have him going in the top 10.
Eric Ebron, I think, because I've watched this kid. He's an all-world athlete. It's just I see him drop. You know, he's not the best blocker in the world. I would like him if my Giants took him at 12.
But guess who needed tight end?
I would like him. But if he falls to the Green Bay Packers, you put him with Aaron Rodgers, boom, that's dangerous right there.
Yes, it is.
They need a tight end. This would make this would be a home run heaven for the Green Bay Packers. Give Aaron Rodgers another weapon like that. Then all they would do is develop with this kid. But Rodgers puts the ball right where he needs to be. So
yes, he'll make any receiver
look
good.
As Stephen A. Smith says, he's a bad man.
He's a bad man.
Yes.
There you go. I can see that, and I think that'd be a gold mine. For the Green Bay Packers. Green Bay Packers, they are in need of a tight end. They're in need of a safety. They're in need of a linebacker as well. But linebackers, again, as we said, the best players are really off the board. So I'm not gonna lie, I'm having trouble picking who I want out of.
I looked at the roster. They don't really have a lot of hands-on
exactly.
needs.
They don't have a lot of needs, and that's why I'm confused. Because other teams, they have needs, and they're like, "What do they need?
People forget they were 8-7-1, but let's forget Aaron Rodgers missed 7 games last year.
Exactly. Looking at tight end after Ebron, as my page loads, you got Jace Amaro. And I mean, frankly, they really do need a tight end.
Yeah.
So I could see them reaching for Jason Merrill out of Texas Tech. But great, he's a projected second-round pick, and they could get him in the second round. I think the Packers may trade down because they're a team that is better than the record was last year, and injuries killed them. So I really see them trading down because I don't know what to pick for them.
Yeah,
I don't know what to do.
Don't have a lot of needs.
So I'm going to say, for the sake of no trade, I'm going to go with Jason Merrill.
Can go very out of their character and trade up.
I mean, I'd be very out of their character.
I mean, they're also a best player available kind of team.
Yeah,
too,
but so. I'm gonna go with. I think they're gonna fill their tight end void, get Jason Merrill, and not take any shots and missing him. Ranked the second best tight end in the draft, so that's where I'm gonna go with that. I'm not confident in that pick at all. Just for the record,
right.
I have no idea what's gonna happen to it. But let's get to 22. The Philadelphia Eagles, 10-6 last year. Who do you have them taking?
I think that they're gonna go like skill guys in the second round. Cause Chip Kelly's real good at developing those guys. I think I don't think they need to go skill position right away here. I think they gotta go on the defensive side of the ball, and I think they're gonna take Ryan Shazier, the outside linebacker from Ohio State. Best defensive player available, in my opinion. I think he would fit their bill on defense. They don't need help all around defense, but. It wouldn't hurt them in any regard. Like it really wouldn't hurt them. They got to go defense, I believe, in this situation. And Shazier makes a lot of sense here. He's the best defense player available. So
I say that with DeShaun Jackson leaving, I think they already need a wide receiver, and that's why they're getting Marquise Lee. This is where I see Marquise Lee going to fill that wide receiver void.
I could see them maybe even taking maybe Brandon Cooks, who spoiler I have going next pick, but we don't have the team yet. But I could see them do it absolutely. But I think Chip Kelly's such a good offensive coach that he can get LeSean McCoy was a second round pick, DeShaun Jackson was a second round pick, Riley Cooper was a fourth round pick, Nick Foles was a second round pick. So they developed these great league offensive players in this later round. So,
And let's go with the number 23 pick, shall we? The Kansas City Chiefs, and let's say your pick again.
Brandon
for
Cooks,
the
I think he fits Reed's system perfectly. Fast guy. They need a receiver, opposite Dwayne Bowe. Badly, it seems like he would compliment Alex Smith greatly. I think I watched film of this kid when I kept hearing that his name was soaring up. So I think Reed would do wonders to this kid. They don't have a lot of needs on defense. I really don't think. I think they just had a bad second half. I think that they still have I think that they maybe could go offensive line, but I don't think there's a lineman really worth taking here now. But I think they got to go. This is a team that doesn't have a lot of glaring needs. That's why they go with a need here, and that's why they go Brandon Cooks.
That's the thing. They need a wide receiver. And if you look, I mean, I already had Cooks drafted. But the player that you had going to the New York Jets.
Odell Beckham.
I have him going to the Kansas City Chiefs.
Which would make sense.
It makes sense. This is just not a good spot for Kansas City because they can go up higher and get a really good player for a spot that they need. Or now they're stuck here at the bottom with no great players in the spots they need, but they can get a decent wide receiver who you can't guarantee will be an immediate impact.
Absolutely.
So they're in a really tricky situation. Really tricky situation for the Kansas City Chiefs. After them, you have an interesting team, the Cincinnati Bengals. They made the playoffs last year once again, but then didn't get a win. Who do you see them picking at the 24th pick?
I think they're going local here, staying in state. They're going Ohio State cornerback Bradley Roby.
Need
a guy to play opposite Leon Hall. They've had Terrence Newman. Drake Kirkpatrick, I don't think he's that good. I really don't. And I think Hall's contract is up after this year, too, as well. So they did invest a lot in Kirkpatrick when they took him, so... I think this is Leon Hall's last year, I believe, in his contract. So I think Roby makes a lot of sense here. Stay local. Go right in the slot this year. And then would they make the secondary pretty good.
I think they need an offensive linebacker. Outside
offensive
linebacker. I saw OLB in outside linebacker.
Do you have a guy designated on the offensive tackle somebody?
Ryan Shazier out of Ohio State. I have him going to the Cincinnati Bengals.
So stay in Ohio. Same school.
Same school.
Same side of the ball. Different positions. Different guy.
Number 25. We go to the San Diego Chargers. Surprised a lot of people last year because of Danny Woodhead. I'm going to credit all Danny Woodhead.
Keenan Allen wants part of this conversation.
Danny Woodhead.
Yes.
to anyone in. Number 25, what do you got the Chargers taking?
They need interior defensive line help. This is where they go with Lewis Nasty Dog Nix, I believe. And apparently, I've read everywhere that they want Lewis Nix. So. Mm-hmm. I've read it everywhere that they want him, apparently. So.
Lewis Nix would be a great one. I'm going to go with Rashida Hagman.
I have no idea who that is until
yeah,
today.
Yeah, but he's
actually
on every single person's draft board at, like, number 20 and, like,
what's
in this
weird
range.
Is actually because I've been checking these every day and hadn't seen his name until today.
Well, he's there, and I trust in the experts, and everyone seems to like him based off the research I did this afternoon. So I'm going to go with the San Diego Chargers taking Rashid Hagman. I'm probably pronouncing his name wrong, and I'm sorry.
And they were in the bottom five last year. The reason I think they would take Nix, they were in the bottom five last year in allowing rushing yards.
They are both defensive tackles, though.
Lewis Nix, very good player, and Rashid, I don't know. I don't even know who this guy is.
Hagman, out of Minnesota. But, again, he's playing well right now. But, again, I agree with you. I think they're going to go defensive line. I think they're going to go someone to stop the run, Lewis Nix, but I'm going to go with Hagman just for devil's advocate.
Makes sense.
All right.
Both same position, so.
Now we get to the 26th pick of the Cleveland Browns. Get this pick from the Indianapolis Colts in the trade for Trent Richardson. The Browns already picked a high early on. Who do you see them going here at 26?
I have them going a very big man. They need a guy opposite Josh Gordon. They need offensive help. Kelvin Benjamin, the Florida State wide receiver, caught the winning touchdown in the national championship game.
Mm-hmm.
6'5". If they take Johnny Manziel, him and Gordon, I think, because you already have Josh Gordon playing opposite you, Kelvin Benjamin, I think, would be. Josh Gordon's already their fast guy and everything, and then you get a tall wide receiver in the red zone. He'd be a very attractive red zone option. Kelvin Benjamin makes a lot of sense for them.
I agree with you. I'm going with a different wide receiver. I'm going Allen Robinson out of Penn State.
Really? Okay. I had Robinson falling in the second round. So.
I think they need a wide receiver as well, but according to NFL draft scout for the New England Patriots on their site, he's a first-round, second-round pick. I saw him play a couple games with Penn State, and I think he did play pretty well. So based off the eye test and me watching him, I like him, and based off what I saw, so why not? I'll have him go in the first
round.
And
for the record, I think that, like, I don't think that all these guys are great, like, first-round talents,
no,
maybe.
No,
but this is a loaded draft class, though. That's why. But, like, mm-hmm. these are good teams that, like, have very little needs. That's why. And I think some of these teams do need offensive linemen, but the wide receivers are better at this point than the offensive linemen are.
Mm-hmm. So. It's a very good point. And it's speaking of a team that kind of could use a wide receiver. An offensive lineman is the New Orleans Saints. They could use an offensive tackle. But they also have some needs at linebacker. Their secondary was a little shaky last year at times. What do you see the Saints taking at 27?
You had them going way earlier than I did, but Kyle Fuller, the cornerback at Virginia Tech. I think the corners fall a lot in the draft, it seems like.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Fuller would be a nice snatch-up for the Saints. They don't have a lot of needs on offense, and even if they did, they have no problem taking a guy in the later round for a skill guy. So I think Fuller makes a lot of sense. They just let Jabari Greer go, who I met, very nice guy. Met him when I was in New Orleans.
He's a good guy.
I met him in New Orleans, very nice guy. But they do have a glaring needed secondary, so that's where I go with Kyle Fuller. They have Curtis Lofton manning the middle for them, so... That's why I'm going Kyle Fuller.
I'm going. I agree with him, Roy. I'm going cornerback because I'm going Jason Verrett out of TCU. I had Fuller going earlier. I had all these cornerbacks going up higher, so that's why I'm into the first round, second round mix bag, if you will. But I got Verrett out of TCU going to the Saints. Same position, just different person.
I like it.
28. We got the Carolina Panthers finished at 12-4 last year. They have a glaring need. How about their wide receiver core? Is there anyone they could pick up this low in the first round?
I have them. I don't think he's good enough to be at this position, but I do think that he fills a need, and that would be Cody Latimer, a wide receiver out of Indiana.
Mm-hmm.
I told you, I had Robinson going in the second round, and I just think that really that they just need any help on wide receiver they can get because they have nothing there. Nothing,
yeah.
It seems. They lost LaFell. They traded away. They got rid of Steve Smith. They have nothing there. They'll take whatever they can get right now.
That's why I'm going with Kelvin Benjamin, who you had going earlier, the tall outside wide receiver. I have him, the 6'5" guy, going to the Carolina Panthers because Cam Newton needs someone the ball to throw to in the red zone or down the field. So I think they have no choice but to take him. Again, not a first-round talent, but it's what they need, and they're not going to take the chance on losing.
They have no
him.
Needs on defense. Their defense is spectacular.
Oh, Luke Kuechly.
Spectacular defense.
Man crush on Luke Kuechly. Now we get to the 29th overall pick, the New England Patriots. Patriots finished at 12-4 last year. I'm gonna tell you right now, I think they trade down. I think they trade down too. I think they trade down to the second round.
They just don't know who.
Yeah, they just
This is where I think maybe Jacksonville could sneak in, maybe take Teddy Bridgewater or Derek Carr or somebody.
Yeah, we've only had two quarterbacks go.
So this is where I think maybe someone could sneak in, but I think if New England stays, they go with a guy, Stephon Tuitt out of Notre Dame.
Okay.
I know it's three Notre Dame guys in the first round, but Stephon Tuitt can play defensive end or defensive tackle, either position you ask. He's a big man. He's very athletic, and they do need defensive line help. I know you just signed Will Smith yesterday. I don't think that helps your defensive line. I think he's a very aging veteran. Bill Belichick is a genius, so therefore he can do whatever. But I think Tuitt will instantly upgrade that defensive line.
Well, someone you had going earlier, I have Lewis Nix. Notre Dame player. I have him going to the Patriots. Defensive tackle, if he can learn under Will Fork. Again, I think Will Smith will be good in spots. I don't think he's going to play the full season starting time every single week because, frankly, the Patriots, they shift their defense every week as to who they're playing. But I think that they're going to really try and shore up that defensive line with Lewis Nix. That's what the Patriots take with 29.
Same schools. Same area, too. Same defensive line.
There you go. Now we get to the San Francisco 49ers, team that went 12-4 last year. Who do you see them taking with a 30th overall pick?
See, this is where I was torn between going with another wide receiver, which I don't think is their biggest immediate need. I think they can get one. See, wide receivers can be gems in the later rounds. That's why. I think a bigger need for them right now is outside linebacker / defensive end, exactly the guy to replace Alden Smith, who I think will be cut at some point this year.
I agree.
That's why I think they go Coney Ealy here out of Missouri. Him and Michael Sam were a duo last year. They were one of the best defense in the SEC. Coney Ealy is better than Michael Sam. Even though Sam won defensive player there, Coney Ealy's a better player. I watched that Cotton Bowl. Coney Ealy was really, really good. Mm-hmm. I don't know why I have him going down so low, but a lot of teams apparently wouldn't take him. So I think he would fall right into San Francisco's lap at number 30.
For number 30, I'm going with Timmy Jernigan out of Florida State, the junior. Defensive tackle. I just think he's a talent, a very good player, and I just frankly think
he looked bad in the national championship.
I know he did.
He looked great when he actually played. It's just he looked gassed. I know because he had the flu apparently, but he looked really out of shape in the national championship.
Well, I think that the 49ers are going to give him a shot, and just because he was on a national championship team, I think they're going to look at the tape of that team and say, listen, he was part of a defense that got all the way to the national championship.
Right.
So that's why I got Jernigan. I have him going 30 to the San Francisco 49ers. Now we get to the two Super Bowl teams, and first the team that laid the dud, the Denver Broncos, at 31, 13-3 last year, an offense that's dynamic and off-season signings that makes their defense pretty dynamic too. What are they going to do with the 31st pick?
Timmy Jernigan.
Okay.
Timmy Jernigan. I think that Terrence Knighton's a really good defensive tackle. I think they do have a needed defensive tackle. They run the 4-3. I actually, up until about an hour ago, had flip-flop. I had agreed with you with Timmy Jernigan with San Francisco and had Coney Ealy at this spot. But then I realized Alden Smith might not be on the team next year. Ealy's a better player, I think, than Timmy Jernigan.
Okay.
So I think that will be a need, so that's why it's San Francisco taking Ealy. Denver, Jernigan fills a need. They got to go defense. Offense needs no help, I don't think, any whatsoever. They were the best offense at NFL.
No, they don't need it. They pay many.
They replaced Eric Decker with Emmanuel Sanders. That's fine by me.
That's an upgrade.
Upgrading, if anything, because I think he's really good. I think Emmanuel Sanders very underappreciated. They got to go defense here. They signed Ware, T.J. Ward, Aqib Talib.
God, they're so good.
Yeah. I don't really think of a lot of linebackers were taken at this spot. Where maybe that could help them, but I got them going Jernigan.
I have Stephon Tuitt, who you have the Patriots taken. Yes. I have him going to Denver Broncos defensive tackle. Like I said, or like you said, excuse me, they could use help at that spot. And I think that he's going to go to the Denver Broncos. You have them going to the rival Patriots, but we flip-flop there.
Yes.
And now finally, the last pick of the first round, the Super Bowl champion, Seattle Seahawks, finished with a 13-3 record last year. They will close out the first round on Thursday. Who do you have them taking?
I have them, if you don't realize this about Seattle, they reach all the time in the first round.
Mm-hmm.
They reach a lot in the first round for guys, but they happen to be home run picks. Like Bruce Irvin, not even just the first round, like when they took Russell Wilson to the third round. People thought, why would you take Russell Wilson in the third round?
Uh-huh.
What are you doing?
Uh-huh.
But I have them reaching for a guy here. They need somebody to throw the ball. Russell Wilson they need to get someone for Russell Wilson to throw the ball to. Mm-hmm. I have them thinking tight end Troy Nicholas from Notre Dame.
Tight end Troy Nicholas from Notre Dame. That is a reach. He's a second to third round projected pick, according to CBS.
Bruce Irvin was a third round pick projected, and he took him at 15 overall. So if they feel a guy is good, they'll take him. They're not shy about that.
Mm-hmm.
But Pete Carroll does like to take guys he's familiar with. And Nicholas, even though he didn't play a lot at Notre Dame, and he takes guys that he's familiar with in college, from college. So Nicholas, Notre Dame guy, Lee Carroll's a USC guy. He took guys like Golden Tate. Richard Sherman went to the rival Stanford. Earl Thomas, when they played it, Earl Thomas was Texas. So he takes guys he's kind of familiar with. So Nicholas is a guy who went to Notre Dame. I think he would be a little familiar with him, and he fills a need. I think too, they need someone to get Russell Wilson to throw the ball to. So. I think this fills a need for them terrifically.
I think that they're going to try and protect Russell Wilson, because I think there were times last year the offensive line slacked, and I'm going to butcher this name so badly. But the offensive guard at UCLA, Xavier Suafilo?
Suafilo.
Suafilo?
I know of him. I think guards tend to go more in the 40s, it seems like, though, unless you're a rare guy like Chance Warmack or Jonathan Cooper.
But, again, yeah. I think that they're going to try and protect him. I think that at times their offensive line struggled a bit last
year. That's very true, yes.
So I think with the 32nd pick, granted, it's not a sexy pick, but I think that they're going to be practical, knowing that they have a great team already that won a Super Bowl. Granted, the receiving corps is not as good because they got rid of Golden Tate. I think they're going to try and protect Russell Wilson. That's why I got them going, Xavier Suafilo.
Which, it does make sense, though. Like, anything on the offense side of the ball that's not a quarterback or a running back would make sense.
I think what's great is we only took two quarterbacks in the first round, both of us. And everyone's been talking about quarterbacks. We both took Johnny Manziel, Blake Bortles in the first round.
We both put a lot of receivers in the first round,
though. We did, because it's a passing league. What are you going to do?
Yeah, so.
What are you going to do? All right, well, that's all the time we have for the BS Report. It's been a fantastic year, Kevin Barnett.
Fantastic. You know, it's 4 years, man. This is our last one. It's only fitting we ended with the NFL draft.
It's only fitting, right? And you are going to have your popcorn ready on Thursday, man. You are going to be all excited.
Man, just 4 years here, I'll just say, man, it's been nothing but a pleasure. You know, like, I got it. Like, you know, my family, my mom and dad, I call them after every show. My grandparents listen to me in Florida, my brother. I got friends who listen every once in a while. It's just all coming down. You got to thank all of them for listening. And I give a shout out to, of course, Demergis as well.
Michael Demergis.
Demergis, fantastic guy. Fantastic guy. He's been a great guy to look up to when we've been at the station for the last 3 years. So it's just been a pleasure. It's been a pleasure with you this year, John. It really has.
It's been a pleasure. You have taught me more about the NFL draft than anyone else I know.
I'm honored. That's my goal in life. And I schooled you. And I schooled you on defensive shortstop.
Yes, you did last week. Yes, you did last week.
I appreciate
you,
that.
You took me to school.
I appreciate
you did.
How you wrote that on the YouTube page, of course, as well.
I have to acknowledge my mistakes. I am humble. And yes, you corrected me.
And I just want to end on one more final thing. We couldn't really get to the NBA. Mark Jackson getting fired, terrible.
Bad decision, we both agree.
I hope he's coming to New York, though. I hope he comes to New York. I would love him over Steve Kerr.
We both agree the front office didn't like Mark Jackson. That's the reason they got rid of him.
Yep.
You lead him to 51 wins, take him to Game 7 against the Los Angeles Clippers, and you're going to fire a guy after two straight winning seasons. I don't get it.
Yeah, and he won a series last year, too.
Yeah, so. Don't get it. Anyway, that's all the time we have for the BS Report. It's been a fantastic year for John Stanko and Kevin Barnett. Till next time.
Till next time.
Thank you for listening. Have a good night, everyone.
Thank you. Babe, I love you.